Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Heather Denniston here with the Junk You Should Know show. It is Friday afternoon. It is Friday the 13th. Dun, dun, dun. So I am wondering, when you come on, please tell me what you're doing on this weekend, this beautiful summer weekend. Also, let me know where you're from, because I'd like to know where viewers are reaching out from, and it makes me happy to connect with people all over the place. So when you start viewing, just put your city or state or province down below. It's a beautiful day here in Idaho at a friend's house, and they were nice enough to let me use their office for our show today. So I'm very excited to get going. And first, as always, we are going to be talking about five fitness hacks for women over 40, but we're going to start with talking about the Change Cave, because that is our sponsor. And thank you to The Change Cave for sponsoring the show. The Change Cave is a 12-module online awesome membership program that is for women who are motivated to take their wellness to the next level. It is excellent PDF content, professional expert speakers that come to join us, newscasts every week, and a monthly mindset webinar. And it is fantastic. And I'm going to leave the link down below in the comments in case you want to just get more information on the Change Cave. It is just $23.99 a month. And that price is actually going to be changing in a little bit. And so if you are interested at all, I would highly recommend checking it out before that price change. We today are talking about fitness hacks for women over 40. I know I have a couple people watching. Please check in and let me know where you're from or questions you might have about fitness over 40, because we like the Junk Show to be interactive. Hi, Belinda. It's so great to see you. And I'm so looking forward to everyone joining me today. It's a great subject. As somebody who's been very, very interested in fitness my whole life, it was a shift when I turned 40 on how fitness that I was traditionally doing kind of became less effective. And so why is that, right? Why do we have issues when we are not 20 anymore, trying to get results like losing weight, maintaining muscle mass, stabilizing our cortisol, working on balance and cognition? These are all things that are issues for women as they approach their fourth, fifth, and sixth decade. So let's just dig into that a little bit, because we need to know the why behind why fitness endeavors should change when we're over 40 so that we are more effective in our pursuits. So number one, I mentioned cortisol. Well, when we turn 40, our cortisol does shift and change, which affects all of our hormones. And cortisol is the stress hormone, and it can be very impacted by certain types of fitness. For example, getting on a treadmill and just going steady pace for an hour. When you're 20, it's fine. When you're over 40, it actually impacts your cortisol balance negatively. And so it's actually doing some damage, and we don't want that. So cortisol does shift in our 40s, and also traditional sort of what we used to think of as a good choice for exercise also impacts our cortisol levels when we're over 40. Lean muscle mass. Every decade, we lose muscle mass. Anytime we're over 30s, it's not a fight to keep it. It's not a fight to maintain. It's a fight to even keep it. And to build it is a whole other ball of wax that is very, very tricky when we're over 40. Hi, Jennifer. And so building that lean muscle mass becomes a much different goal than we have when we're younger, because a lot of times when I'm training younger women, they're like, I don't want to get bulky, I don't want this, I don't want that. First of all, as women, we're not going to get bulky if we train correctly. It's food that makes us bulky, not weight training. And over 40, we absolutely have to be subjecting our limbs to gravity, which means weight training is an excellent choice. Not only because we, my husband, who has been waiting so patiently for the Junk You Should Know show to air, and then we can get in the car and drive back to Seattle, just was outside the window doing a dance to try to distract me while I'm talking to you. And it's not going to happen. because we're talking about lean muscle mass and its importance. So as we age, the muscle mass just start, we start to lose it, right? You don't move it, you lose it. And we have to work very hard, but also think about bone composition as well, right? If we are not subjecting our bodies to good gravity impacting type exercise, not swimming, not riding a bike, but weight training, running, jumping, anything that puts you in contact with gravitational forces is good. And so we need to be thinking about that when we're over 40, both the idea that we're losing muscle mass and also the impact on bone density, of course, right? Balance. A lot of people don't realize that even in our 40s, we start to use our ability to have exceptional balance like we do when we're younger, right? We all know that it gets harder. If you were hi, Jess. If you were asked to walk along a pony wall, foot in front of foot, on top of a, you know, 4-inch pony wall, we used to be able to do that as kids pretty easily. But as we start to age, our balance starts to degrade and it's just not as good anymore. And that sets us up for falls and spills, sets us up to pull away from life even more if we're worried about our balance. And then we have less activity and we have quicker degenerative change. And so incorporating balance into all of our workouts over 40 is absolutely necessary. And sometimes it's just overlooked. And finally, cognition. I'm sad to say, folks, that over 40, we start to lose cognitive ability or have the potential to lose cognitive ability. And things like dementia, Alzheimer's, all those brain diseases that can approach as we get older can be staved off or prevented by vigorous physical exercise because we know movement is the energy for the brain. I always liken it to the crank flashlight. How do you make a crank flashlight work? When you spin that handle and the light turns on, that's what happens in our bodies when we move. That brain dumps happy hormones. It's an anti-aging for the brain. And so knowing that as our cognition is changing, that exercise becomes even more and more and more important. So keeping that in mind. So we said cortisol, loss of lean muscle, balance, cognition, of course, everyone's favorite, weight gain. Somehow when we turn 40, weight starts to move and shift around our bodies in ways we don't appreciate. And we gain weight much more quickly than ever before. And so fat burning type exercise, which a lot of folks still think is walking on a treadmill for an hour, is absolutely necessary. But we need to understand what fat burning exercise looks like for women over 40. So we're going to jump right in, people. I would, again, love to know anybody who's signing on, especially if you're watching in replay, because I always circle back and connect with the comments and we'll answer questions as you guys put them below. So number one, because we're talking 5 fitness hacks for women over 40. Intervals, my favorite. Everybody knows I love intervals if you know anything about me, because I like efficiency. I like maximum or minimum effective dose, which comes from Tim Ferriss and the 4-Hour Body. Hey, Christine, great to see you. Maximum minimum effective dose is what is the least amount we can put in to get the most out of something, and intervals in regard to fitness are it. And when you do interval work, it speeds metabolism, it burns fat, you have an afterburn that occurs after you've worked out that goes much longer than any steady pace kind of exercise you might be doing. And so there are so many paybacks, and yes, they are tricky and a little bit harder and definitely more, you know, more of a challenge, but they are fun and it makes your workout go so much more quickly and so effective. So what do I mean by intervals for those of you that may not know? Well, it means a time period of hard work and a time period of almost no work. And those time periods are usually a minute or less, sometimes up to 2 minutes, but typically a minute or less. And so the idea is, let's say you stood and just did running on the spot. Well, you might do it for 30 seconds, take a 30-second rest, 30 seconds, 30-second rest, 30 seconds, 30-second rest. That would be a type of interval. There's different kinds. Many of you have heard of HIIT, high-intensity interval training. Tabata is a 20-second hard, 10-second rest. There's a AMRAP. I was like, I can't remember how to say it. As many rounds as possible. And that's a tight kind of a type of interval. And then EMOM, which is every minute on the minute, is definitely an interval. These are all workout methods, and I'll put a link to the explanation of those down below, but these are all workout methods that are super, super effective. They're interval style, and they get that up, down, that makes your body work harder and makes it burn longer after you're long finished your workout. You know, when you drive a car on a highway, it is definitely less effort for the car than if you turn on the car, turn off the car, turn on the car, turn off the car, right? And that's kind of a good visualization for how intervals work in our body. Okay, number two, core imbalance, because we just talked about that even at 40, we start to use our ability to balance. We lose our proprioception that we had so acutely when we were kids. And so working on that to maintain that not only improves cognitive function, because balance and cognition are very closely related, but it improves core strength. It improves so many different aspects that we start to struggle with when we're over 40. So what kinds of things can we do for core balance? Well, the simplest one that I like is when you're doing a workout, think to yourself, how can I challenge my balance with this? So for example, if you are, say you're weight training and you're doing some bicep curls, stand on one foot. That incorporates balance. It's very easy. It makes you engage that core, right? And so super, super effective. And then as far as just core goes in general, women and men all tend to suffer at least one incident of back issues as they're getting older. I think it's up to 80% at this point. And if we do not address our core, I can, from a chiropractic standpoint, and Dr. Jennifer, who's watching, can also attest, if you do not spend any time on your core, then you will have a back episode at some point. It's just, they're too interrelated. And so incorporating some planks, some abdominal work, and consistently and regularly throughout your week is absolutely essential, because your core is probably one of the fastest weakening muscle groups that you own in your body. And we need to keep them on fire. Okay, quick little core test. A lot of people don't know how to tighten their tummies correctly. My favorite way to teach a client how to do it is the shush. And what I'm talking about is, if you wanted to tell a bunch of kids across the parking lot to be quiet, you could go shh as hard as you can, right? So they can hear you. So put your hand on your belly and let's practice our shushing. Shush as hard as you can. Shh. Do you feel how your belly tightens in that situation? Often it's different than what you might think a good abdominal contraction is, but that shushing is exactly how you need to be contracting your core. So when you're doing planks or sit-ups or standing on one leg in a bank lineup, engage your core correctly. You don't have to shush every time once you get used to how it's done, and be practicing that regularly. I do shushing in the car all the time. I practice engaging my core. Whenever I'm leaning over, I kind of over-accentuate and just really work on firing those muscles, maybe hold the position a little longer so that we can be challenging. Because what I'm doing right now, which I typically don't when I'm on the Junk You Should Know show, but in the environment I'm in, I don't have a standing place to do our video, but sitting, of course, is death to the core. Just shuts it right off and just immediately starts to weaken. And for those of you that sit, you need to be doing even more core, even if you're not 40. Number three, flexibility. Sadly, also something we lose very rapidly over 40. And if we do not work our flexibility, our cartilage becomes very dehydrated and goes from feeling like rubber to phyllo pastry, and it sets us up for injury. It sets us up for so many changes in our quality of life in decade 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and however long you're going to live if we don't work the flexibility feature. So one thing that I recommend is literally one yoga or stretch class a week. Flexibility is great to do every day, but if you're not getting hardly any in, you can see benefits with just one class a week or one little 15-minute stretch session a week. And what's one of the best things you can do for flexibility? Who can answer me? they're all the rage and they're round and they look like a pool noodle, foam roller, right? And we did a junk show last week on how to foam roller, and they are one of the best ways to get intersegmental flexibility that is very difficult for us to do on our own. And so not only gross body stretching, but also teeny tiny little flexibility hits throughout the week using a foam roller is excellent. Alrighty, so flexibility. Yoga, Pilates, all amazing. So you could certainly consider that. Next, functional strength. I don't know about you, but I want a suitcase in the overhead bin. I want to be able to snorkel off the coast of New Zealand when I'm 80. And if we are not practicing functional movement in our workouts, it's not going to happen. And what does that mean? Well, it used to be that weight training was about defining the most perfect muscle. Good job, Jess. Defining the most perfect muscle. Ahem, like David. Oh, I don't know what you mean by that, Jess. It's not anymore, because we've realized that, first of all, that very specific Nautilus type workouts can create imbalances in your body and problems and injuries and all of that kind of thing. So we need to practice movements that we do every day: pushing, pulling, lunging, squatting, reaching, rotation. Those are functional movements that our bodies need to do when we are lifting garden soil, picking up puppies, reaching for dishes out of the top shelf. We need to train for life. And so functional strength training is absolutely key. And here's the bonus. When you functionally train, you are creating so much more efficiency in your workout, because I'm sorry, but a push-up or a pull-up or a tricep dip is so many muscle groups you're working. Instead of just doing a bicep curl, you're working one muscle. Whereas when you are doing some kind of body-wide type functional exercise, like a lunge or a squat, or like I said, a push-up, you are utilizing multiple muscle groups, training them all at one time in a functional way. And isn't that just the most effective, right? So good thing about functional fitness is everybody is jumping on board. So places like Orange Theory, CrossFit gyms, stuff like that. Not that I recommend CrossFit, but all of the rage right now is creating a functional component in our fitness routine. And so, lovely, we have some apps: 7-minute workout, Fitness Blender, Swerkit, all of those I'll list below. Those are really simple, free apps, except for Fitness Blender, that you can use to create functionality in your workout. Because you might go, well, other than a push-up, I don't know what exercises to do. These will provide them for you, which is really awesome. Okay, if there's any questions, just shoot them up there, guys. Last one, protein. Who knows how many grams per kilogram of body weight of protein you should be getting every day? So how many grams of protein per kilogram of body weight should you be getting every day? Does anybody know, as a woman? I'll let you think about it. It's typically more than you think. And I think the recommendation, the national recommendation, is low. I think for energy, for maintaining muscle, and all of those kinds of things, I think we just need to be focusing on protein more. It's just my opinion. And so how do we do that? Well, we start with our protein choice with snacks and meals, if you are a snacker. And you think, what can I have that is protein rich? And so making sure that things like, instead of chips, you reach for a breast of chicken, a hard-boiled egg, bacon-wrapped avocado, something like that, you know, so that you're getting nice, healthy fats and great proteins, and you're adding more protein to your day. MyFitnessPal is a great way to monitor your nutrition, because they have a pie chart on there that you can look at the end of the day that defines how much protein, carbohydrate, and fat you ingested for the day. And it's a super great little check to say, oh, I'm only at 20% protein a day. You might want to be a little higher. So to come back and answer that question, it's 0.8 grams per kilogram of body weight according to the NASM guidelines. And that's the National Academy of Sports Medicine. And that's what they recommend. But frankly, when I do the math for my body weight, for me, that feels low. And so my recommendation is really, lots of protein is great. And if you are a vegetarian or a vegan, you've got to work even harder, obviously, because it is tough to get enough protein from plant-based diet. It's not impossible by any means. But also, I have had some clients that have tried to over-supplement their protein instead of trying to get it from whole food. Nothing wrong with supplementing protein. I'm a big fan, as many of you know, of collagen protein, particularly I like Vital Proteins. There's lots of good ones out there. And also branched chain amino acids, big fan of those to get energy for your workout, to help build lean muscle, and so much, much more. So certainly supplement, but make sure you are working very hard to get that from whole food. Oh, Valerie, I'm so glad. Thanks for joining. Okay, so we're just going to do a recap. Recap. So we're talking about fitness hacks for women over 40, and why we need it is because over 40, we get cortisol issues, we get losing lean muscle mass, we get balance and cognition issues, and weight, of course. So our five ways of changing our workout over 40, so they're way more effective, is intervals like HIIT or Tabata, working core and balance way more. So sorry, more planks. Flexibility, at least once a week, getting 15 minutes minimum just on flexibility, okay? And do it in front of the TV, guys. If you are watching TV at all, no excuses for not adding some of this stuff in here. Functional strength, because we are building for our future. We are massaging and loving our inner elder, our inner septuagenarian, and saying, I care about your life. And so I'm going to work on reaching, twisting, squatting, lunging, all of those functional moves that are so popular right now anyway. And you can use apps like 7-Minute Workout, Fitness Blender, Swerkit, and there's lots of others. If any of you know others, just post them down there below. Finally, protein, minimum 0.8 grams per kilogram of body weight per day. Do the math and start there, but certainly you can move up from there too. Okay, so guys, I've loved hanging with you today, and I will be back next Friday at noon. So please, please come back and bring a friend, okay? And enjoy the show next. Well, last week's show was great. It was on foam roller. So if you didn't see that one, that was with Kyle Stoll from Trigger Point, who puts out the best foam rollers ever. And it was so great to catch him at the IDEA conference in San Diego. And that was awesome. And I've been starting to repost some of the old shows because I'm getting requests for them. And there were a few there that just were a big hit. So put a few of those back out into the social network. Watch for those. And I look forward to seeing you next week. And remember, the Change Cave is sponsoring the show. There's a link right there for you to go and check out more about the program. Again, the price is changing shortly. The price right now is $23.99, and that will be going up. So take advantage right now by clicking through that link, bit.ly/BigTBigCBigCLAND. Okay. I will be circling back to any of those that watched in the replay and answering questions. I'll be making some posts down below. So if you wanted any of the links that I talked about, they will be there. And I appreciate you and love you so much. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Jess, great to see you. And all of the other folks, Christine, Jennifer, and Valerie, and all of the other folks that watch live, I sure appreciate you coming by here on a Friday at noon. All right, I'll talk to you later, guys. Love you.